Sometimes this will be more classical than the other one, because it consider an essentially divisor, but let me give some introduction and some notation. So we would like to take always the previous notation, so S will be an algebraic surface, and I would like to consider the Neron Severi group, which is the peak of X mod out by peak zero. And this is the from the point of view of divisor mod out by algebraic equivalence. The dimension of S is 2, but for many things let's call S. Division on S mod the very equivalence, or which is in the case of divisor is like the homological equivalence. Okay. So pick a class lambda A. Maybe the map, the quotient map, can be identified like the first chain class. So this is a line bundle. The first chain class go in H2Z, and the Neron Severi is isomorphic to the image of the first chain class. Yeah, it's a mistake. So are the line bundle with this first chain class, and we take a class and we define P lambda of S is just test of the line bundle such that the class L is lambda, or if C1 of L is lambda, if we make this identification. And we have also now we remark that P lambda is not an abelian variety, but is a torsor. Means that if we can fix a point, if we fix L in P lambda, then we have an isomorphism just by take the tensor in by L. So when we fix a point here, well, this is like a fine space. It's not an abelian variety, but is isomorphic to an abelian variety. And in particular, when we fix L, we will the tangent to peak lambda at L is still isomorphic to the tangent of peak zero at zero. And this is H1OS, as we have seen. I will be back. We have also div lambda, which are the effective divisor. Sometimes, I don't know if put also the zero, maybe not, such that OSC belongs to peak lambda. So these are the case of the curves. Remark, in dimension one case, also pick the non-severe group is isomorphic to Z, and C1 is the degree. So pick D is pick D, and div D is the symmetric product of a curve. And also we have the map, which is the Abel-Jacobi map. Also here we have in general the map from div lambda to pick lambda, and we can call this map, I don't know, B. Maybe not a good name, but the image of B I call vo lambda, and maybe also can define W. So these are the line bundle L, such that H0 of L is bigger than 0. So maybe it's better just to avoid some triviality. And you can define also the Brill-Noether. Loci, as in the case of the curves, so this in peak lambda, obviously. So they are the L in peak lambda, such that the H0 of L is bigger or equal than L plus 1. And there are many problems, very basic problem. In the case of the curves, many things are known on the structure. Obviously, it's known, completely known, div lambda, and also the Brill-Noether loci are known by the theory of Brill-Noether. And then, in the case of surfaces, so higher dimension, also div lambda is not clear. Some problem. Find a condition in such a way that div lambda and clearly v lambda are not empty. Obviously, if lambda is very, very big, very positive, then H0 of L by the vanishing, by ser vanishing or whatever, becomes the characteristic of L, and this is very, and this is a very ample stuff. This is bigger than zero, and so this is known, but the problem is not when this is very positive, but
it means very positive, or
yeah, very positive. So ample. Also, if it is very ample, it's clear that it's not. There are a class that is very, very positive. So find then. Remark that second one. Find condition. Suitable condition such that the map from div lambda to peak lambda is surjective. It is, for instance, in the curve case, one need d bigger or equal than g by Jacobi inversion theorem. So C generically, CD injects, injects, generically is birational onto its image for D less or equal than G, and then becomes surjective. When it's surjective, when this map I call maybe stupid B, When B is surjective, also in general, but let me say, find when B is surjective, one as a component. Of div lambda, that only one component, a unique, that dominates peak lambda. In fact, the fiber are projective space. The fibers are the projective space associated to L, and so are irreducible. This component is called div lambda main, usually. And a question could be, so There are other components. This component are called exorbitant. In particular, the most studied case, maybe the only one that we now understand, is the case when we take small k, maybe try to the C1 of the canonical band or the canonical device, the canonical divisor. In this case, we call div K is the paracanonical system. And first thing, remark that div, in general, div lambda, when it's not empty, is a subset of the Hilbert scheme, an Hilbert scheme of curves on S, so it has a structure. I don't know if there is in general the equality here, because could be immersed component. Certainly it is a component, I believe that it was the full Hilbert scheme, but then someone said, maybe there are curves with some immersed component with the same. I'm not sure. Anyway, this show that give a structure, scheme structure of div lambda, although it could be very bad. I would like to discuss in particular the result. To remark that obviously the canonical system K of S is contained in the paracanonical system. So instead of writing this, I write just P. So I would like to know now, for instance, now question one, when this this is not empty. For instance, if PG is bigger than zero, so for instance, if PG is bigger than zero, we know that P is not empty because there are some kind of curve, and more or less this is also the condition. You can try, maybe there are some small cases, but I don't want to consider now. And the second question is when this is an old question, when this is in peak k of s is surjective. Let me remark that this is canonically isomorphic to peak 0 of S, because we have the canonical class here. So fixing the canonical class and taking L to K minus L, we have an isomorphism from here to here. Is the, and also that has a good behavior with the cohomology by duality. And this object, this was a problem of Enriquez. And it was quite important in it was a work of Catanese, and I think inspired by this work leads or motivated Green and Lazarsfeld to look for the so-called generic vanishing that give a good answer to this problem when this is surjective. And in fact we have the following result. Following result, assume, so theorem, generic vanishing. I state only the case of the surface, but there is so consider, let P1, the set of the line bundle L in peak 0, but also peak K works by duality, such that H1 of L is bigger than 0. So this is Green-Lazarsfeld. Then assume that the Albanese map alpha from S to A is generically finite. In higher, then, let me say part one, this V1 is strictly contained in peak zero of S, or peak K, by duality. And the second one is that V1 is a finite union of translated torsion point translation of subabelian variety. So this is due to Simpson, the last part. So in general you have not just result by V1, but you have result by V1, V2, V0, V1, and V0 is trivial. Because where V0 is just the zero, which is not zero. And so using this, anyway, using this result, you see that if L in peak zero, L is not in V1, then the characteristic of L, which is the characteristic of K minus L, remark that V0, V0 is undefined, so remark that the point zero O is contained in V1, because H1 of O is Q, that must be bigger than 2, because this, this should be generically finite. So this one is just the H0 of K minus L, because H1 and H2 are 0. So but this characteristic, L is in peak 0, so this is like the characteristic of K, which is the characteristic of O. So we see that H0 of K, if L is generic in peak K, okay, let's change the name. M is generic. H0 of M is PG minus Q plus 1. And then, for instance, when it is of general type, this becomes if S of general type, this one is certainly bigger than 0. We know when good estimate when we have no irrational pencil, but I didn't give the Bouvier estimate, but it's also true that PG is bigger than 2Q minus 4 in general. And so because of this, we have that the map from peak from P lambda to PK, from the paracanonical system to PK, is surjective. And also we can see that this so when we take P main, the fiber of this map have dimension the fiber as as f dimension chi minus 1, because are the projective are the projectivization of M. And so the dimension of P min is Q plus key minus 1, which is PG. Okay, so the dimension of this main component is PG. Remark that instead the dimension of the canonical system is PG minus 1. So the question and the theorem, now I address to the last question, if there are some exorbitant component. In particular, I would like to know if this canonical system is a component or is contained in P min. And the result is quite surprising. I different.
L'altro Beauville. That says that K is containing P9, the component of P9, the closure, correct, I think. Assume that S has no irrational pencil of genus Q of genus bigger or equal than Q half, then K is containing P minus if and only if Q is odd. So if Q is odd, it's contained. If Q is even, no. There is so if Q is odd. So I'd like to discuss this result. And I would like also to remember that we have I will prove the result I discuss, so let's give the proof. But I give the proof in a simplified case when S has no irrational of genus bigger equal than 2. But it's only in the linear algebra part that I will show that we use this. So you have to work a little more in the algebraic part, in the linear algebra part. It's not. And also, in higher dimension, using essentially the idea that I will show now, using the idea, these ideas, and the work plus the work of Lazarsfeld-Popa, which is BGG stuff, we prove that if dimension of X is bigger than 2, K is contained in P if plus some hypothesis on that generalizes the irrational pencil, so plus not irrational vibration that I would like just that as a geometric explanation, but just to be self-contained, let's say, is for us is that this map does not contain the composable element. It can be explained again by like in the Frankis explained by Catanese, but it can be explained that there are not some vibration from the surface to other irregular surfaces of Albany general type, and also assume that Q is bigger than N, then K is contained, so this is the assumption.
So X is S, or?
Yeah, by dimension n. Okay, so we call x, but because we are in dimension n, surfaces.
Huh? Does not
necessarily
to be a surface.
No, I just say now for one moment the case when the higher dimension.
But then this assumption.
No, this assumption is for surface.
This
is a little divagation, something like this. Just to say that it is something to say. What happens is that in this case it's very restrictive to be, because we have to have q equal to n plus 1. So just in a sense divisor in abelian variety. Make a mistake. N is equal to q minus 1. So yeah, divisor in abelian variety. And also a numerical condition that now, if I don't mind, is pg is equal to k of k plus q minus 1, something like this. I didn't remember completely, but it's very, very restrictive condition, plus this. So, smooth divisor in abelian variety, things that with some singularity that are similar to this. So this is my joint work with Margarita Mendez-Lopez and Rita Pardini. So we generalize this result of Bovini in higher dimension. But the idea are more or less, and it's more complicated, but So I will read the proof. So in any case, it shows that the surface case for the paracanonical system are very special. So obviously for the curves there's no problem. This canonical is because we are in symmetric. The symmetric product of a curve is always irreducible. So curves, surfaces of Q odd, and let's say divisor in abelian variety. So the most natural variety, a regular variety that one consider usually. Okay. So to give an idea of the proof, first we need there are two points. We need a fact from infinitesimal deformation of section of Alain Bandon. So I use only for k, but let me start with L and assume that you have S in E0 of L. Then we have say that we would like to deform L. So to take, say, if this is peak lambda, lambda is the first same class of L, we take a curve, maybe an infinitesimal curve, an infinitesimal line bundle. So maybe just write this. I think this the global family, and you have a section on the central fiber. L0 is L, and this deformation is classified by the tangent. The deformation L are classified by the tangent to peak lambda at the point L, and this is H1 of O, and
And so this is just so this is like a curve, and we have just one first, the first direction, which is h1 of O. And in fact, just to give an idea why this is so, you start with g alpha beta that are the transition function of L, and sigma alpha beta, which are the transition function. This is in H1 of O star, because this is a multiplicative, this is an additive function of H1, of the class V in H1 of O, and then G alpha tilde beta is G alpha beta 1 plus sigma alpha beta. You write like this, and a T. And it is satisfying at up to the first order the condition of cocycle. And the condition to the form, the condition to the form S in the direction V is that the cup product map V is here, S is here, and then V by S should be zero. I don't know if I have to prove this. Is very it's very easy. You write down the section S alpha here, and then you know that G alpha beta of S alpha is S beta, and then you deform S alpha plus T alpha, use this one, and you find at the first order exactly the condition this one to be zero. It's an exercise in standard exercise. So assume this. So we see that now we use, now instead of L we take the canonical, and we have a map from H0 of K to H1 of K. And then we start with a form omega, and to the form, at least we have to find we have to know if this is can be deformed in the general point. So we have to find to the form omega. We take omega to the form the curve associated. We have to find a direction where at least the first order deformation, the direction V in H1 of O, the first order deformation does not give problem. So we need to find, for any omega, we need to find V in H1 of O different from zero, such that V by omega is zero. This is the first step. Otherwise we cannot see if there are no, we have finish, and this is exorbitant component. But now there is a stupid lemma. It's called stupid lemma, but it was the lemma. It's not so stupid, maybe. It's easy, but take general. omega in H0, okay? The general canonical form or curve, then consider the map L omega that send H1O to H1K. So we fix now here and we look at and the kernel. So L omega of V is omega by V, and the kernel of L omega, the dimension of this kernel is less or equal than 1. So there is just one direction. Let me give the proof. Assume by contradiction that the kernel, the dimension is bigger than 1, so it contains at least two elements, V1 and V2, independent in H1 of O. Omega V1 equal to omega V2 equal to 0. But now we use a little Hodge theory. This H1 of O, if you recall, I recall you that each H1 of O is the H0 of omega 1 bar, and we can use instead of using Czech homology as before, we can use Dolbach homology, and we can represent V1 and V2 as two harmonic form. So we can represent V1 as the class of V1 omega 1 and V2 as the class omega 2 bar. And then we can cook up another. This is not algebraic completely because this is bar. Now we have used this. We can cook up now another canonical form, omega 1 by omega 2. And we can play around and find a family, a linear family of canonical form, but this is the general one, and this is, we have just add, this is wedge of the kernel. If we do this, we know that the kernel, we have taken omega general, so the kernel must be minimal. So the kernel must deform, as we deform in any direction, deform omega. Otherwise, the kernel omega is not generic from the point of view of the kernel. The kernel go down by semi-continuity, by linear semi-continuity, the metric semi-continuity. But so what does it mean? It means that if we take omega 1 bar, which is in the kernel of omega, so omega by omega 1 bar is 0 in the sense that it becomes an exact form, because we use this exact form. It must be the form. So we must find alpha 1 and then etc., something like this. But up to the first order, we can take this and take again the first order, the history, and we find the relation omega by a right wedge, because when we take form, this must be exact again, so zero in cohomology. Omega by minus this one, minus alpha 1, plus omega 1, omega 2, omega 1 bar is equal to 0. But then we can multiply by omega 2 bar. And then we have minus here, it's not important, by alpha 1 bar, by omega 2 bar. But this by this is exact. So omega 1, omega 2, by omega 1, omega 2 bar. So this is exact, so this one must be exact too. But we can integrate on S, this one. But when we integrate on S, this is the bar of this. You write it in local coordinate, it becomes something like f squared the x takes the y. So it's positive. Maybe you have to multiply. You have to multiply by I in front. But so this is zero, it means that to be zero, f must be zero. But f
f dx dy is omega in local coordinates. This means that omega 1 by omega 2 is 0, and then we have irrational pencil. So the kernel is less or equal than 1, and then we go back to this map. So this map is A0 is H1O to H1K, but after some dualization, you take this in this part and this in the other part. This is equivalent by duality to a map which is H1O to H1O to H2O. You pull this in this part and this in this part. But this, you know, is the dual of the map that we study for a long time. And anyway, is anti-symmetric. Because it is anti-symmetric, when we look at this map, this becomes an anti-symmetric map. This is the dual of this. This is anti-symmetric. So the rank must be even. But when now Q is odd, we know that there is some kernel. And the general one must be of dimension 1. But when Q is even, the rank must be even, and the kernel must be even, but must be less or equal than 1. So for omega general, omega, this map is an isomorphism. But this means that cannot be deformed. So this is the first part of the result. In the second part, I think the result of Bovillo were incomplete and were completed by using the Green-Lazarsfeld result. The second paper, but there is also a very nice paper of Clemens and Eichhorn. Maybe the thesis of Eichhorn, I think, or on generic vanishing. And it says that in our case, it says that for no higher obstruction. So as soon as you have for the canonical or for the something which is the cohomology classes, if you have infinitesimal no obstruction at the first order, you have no obstruction anywhere, no higher obstruction. So if no infinitesimal first order obstruction, then we have for canonical, let's say for it's more general, but you need some flat bundle. And then no obstruction. This is a very strong result. It's more stronger than the generic vanishing by itself, and this is the one that allow you to prove that you have a subabelian variety, so translated of subabelian variety only. Fortunately, I have only 5 minutes, so I can. It is a consequence of the Didi-Bar lemma. I don't know if I can prove now.
Maybe I try. 5 minutes. I think. Last 5 minutes are. So the problem is we in the book homology. No, maybe I don't. I'll try. Homology. So start with H0 of L, and we go to H1 of L, and with our V, we can, this is the first order deformation, we can interpret in another way the deformation, the most classical. So L can be seen, so we have an operator d bar L, and d bar L is an operator that sends the C infinity function section of L to H1, 0, 1 forms on L. So are the 1, 0 form. So something like locally in this form. And the kernel of d bar L is exactly the sheaf L. So there is this L which is in the kernel of this map. And then when you make deformation, you try to deform, what you do, you deform, this is a sheaf, this is OSL. You think to deform this sheaf. But instead to deform the sheaf, you can try to deform the operator. And one way to deform the operator, which is the simpler one, is taking this omega bar, where this omega bar give V in H1O. But if this is a closed form, it turns out this operator, this is, let's call D bar LT, the square is zero. So it's integrable. And it gives a first order deformation of L. Is the version, instead of Czech homology, in Verbeek homology, of exactly the same computation I gave before. But then, and also has the meaning, if we take peak zero and we go to peak lambda, and then here we have H1 of O, and then we take here the exponential. This is a line here to the level, and it represents the exponential here, and then we tensor by L and we go there. Obviously, in general, you just not to take this one, but you have to take T2 plus some other one if you want to some. But yeah, you can use this. And then you can take the section S1 plus TS2 plus S is the first one, S1, and then T square S2, and go on. And since here it's very simple because you have not taken second order deformation but just linear one, the conditions are very similar. So the first order gives just that S must be holomorphic, as we know. Then the second one, it gives that D bar of S1 plus omega bar by S, so this with this, and this with this is, and this with this is the one with T, this zero, and means that the cup product of this and this is zero, and then D bar of S2 plus omega bar by S1 is zero. If you have more complicated, you have, but these are just two pieces, and then you see you can try to understand what does it mean, this one. If you take here the kernel and here the co-kernel, you start with S that must be in the kernel of the multiplication by V. So S is in K. But now you would like to take this one. Now you see easily by taking d bar of this that this is zero. You have to solve this. No, but you don't know. You don't know if this is absolution or not. But what you know is when you take this one and you take the bar, this is zero because of the first equation. It appears another omega, and omega by omega is zero. So certainly it's closed. But then what that depends? It depends if you S1 is not well been defined. You can add any global section of L and give again the solution. And then what is well defined is a map from the kernel to the co-kernel, from here to here. Because, and so on. You go on in that way. In the particular case of the canonical, when you have this kind of result, your d-bar L is the d-bar of the form, because this is now is a canonical, and this is something which is H1O, and again a canonical. But then you have the d-bar lemma. Instead of writing just this, you can choose S1 in a very special way. You can write d bar d sigma equal to omega bar by S minus something like this, and then you can plug you have to take this S1, you can take in this form, you can take the epsilon in that way, you have to multiply again by omega, and then we know that this is closed, but this is also exact because this is d bar closed, and also we can write this in omega by epsilon. So d is delta exact, because d bar closed and d delta exact. You have again the d bar lemma, so you can solve this equation and find S2 and go on in that way. So using d bar lemma, so Hoche theory, not very complicated, but you can go on and. So in the odd case, you have the first order deformation, you can deform. One can remark that you can plug in this way, and after a finite number of steps, this sequence must stop, in general. And in particular, there is a nice result that is maybe very standard from the point of view of deformation. Is if you have something like this, that h0 minus h0 is bigger than 0, then also this is the dimension of k minus the inverse 1. We need the inverse 1. So it's the same, so it becomes 0. At the end, it becomes the same. So we can find at the end some subset of the form here that deform in all the direction. So the condition that H0 is bigger than H1, that in the case of the standard of curves, it gives that the degree must be bigger than the genus, give again that you can deform, and give again a proof of in general of the under this condition of a generalization of Jacobi inversion theorem by using some deformation. But this invariant is not so easy to control. But for some reason, when they are equal, it becomes very a problem. I think I stop, and I thank you. And so there are many problems in this area, but for instance, this problem is open. Thank you very much.